Hello, welcome to the Data Structure and Algorithms online tutorial video. In the last video, we learned about the linked list, and in this video, we will learn about stacks. Let us have a quick look on overview of the things you are going to learn in this video. We will learn what is stack, how does stack work, standard operations of stack, push operation, pop operation, and applications of stack. First, we will understand what is stack. The stack is the last in first out data structure. Stack is like a pile of plates. In the beginning, the pile may be empty, but eventually the plate can be added to the pile. Only the most recently added plate can be removed first, which is last in first out. The last plate in is the first plate out. Stacks are used to implement functions, passes, expression evaluation, and backtracking algorithms. Now let us see how does stack work. Stack works on the LIFO pattern, that is last in first out principle. Suppose we want to store the elements in a stack and consider an empty stack of size 4 in which we are pushing the elements one by one until the stack becomes full. The stack gets filled up from bottom to the top. When we perform the delete operation on the stack, there is only one way for the entry and exit, as the other end is closed. It follows the LIFO pattern, which means that the value entered first will be removed last. In the figure you can see the value 1 is entered first, so it will be removed only after the deletion of the all other elements. Standard operations of stack. Inserting an element in a stack is known as push. If the stack is full, then the overflow condition occurs. Deleting an element from the stack is known as pop. If the stack is empty, means that no element exists in the stack, this state is known as underflow state. IsEmpty determines whether the stack is empty or not. IsFull determines whether the stack is full or not. Peek returns the element at the given position. Count returns the total number of elements available in the stack. Change operation changes the element at the given position. Display prints the all elements available in the stack. Now we will see the push operation. For performing the push operation, following steps are to be considered. Before inserting an element in a stack, we check if the stack is full. If we try to insert the element in the stack that is full, then the overflow condition occurs. While we initialize a stack, we set the value of the top as -1 to check that the stack is empty. When a new element is pushed in a stack, first the value of the top gets incremented, that is top is equal to top plus 1, and the element will be placed at the new position of the top. The element will be inserted until we reach the max size of the stack. As you can see here, initially the stack is empty and the top is equal to -1. The elements are inserted one by one until the stack gets full. Next we will see pop operation. Before deleting the element from the stack, we check whether the stack is empty. If we try to delete the element from the empty stack, then the underflow condition occurs. If the stack is not empty, we first access the element which is pointed by the top. Once the pop operation is performed, the top is decremented by 1, that is, top is equal to top minus 1. Applications of stack. Stack is used for balancing a symbol. For reversing a string, first we push all the characters of the string in a stack until we reach the null character. After pushing all the characters, we start taking out the character one by one until we reach the bottom of the stack. It can also be used for performing undo or redo operation in an editor. Suppose there are three states A, AB and ABC which are stored in a stack. There would be two stacks in which one stack shows undo state and the other shows redo state. The recursion means that the function is calling itself again to maintain the previous states. The compiler creates a system stack in which all previous records of the function are maintained. Depth first search. This search is implemented on a graph and graph uses the stack data structure. Backtracking. While solving a maze problem, in order to come at the beginning of the path to create a new path, we have to use the stack data structure. Stack can also be used for expression conversion. This is the one of the most important application of stack. Infix to prefix, infix to postfix, prefix to infix, and prefix to postfix. The stack manages the memory. Memory is assigned in the contiguous memory blocks. The memory is known as the stack memory, as all variables are assigned in a function called stack memory. For detailed notes and examples, you can install the DSA application from Google Play Store or from the link given in the description below. Please like the video, subscribe to our channel, and don't forget to hit on bell icon to get notified whenever we post new videos. Thank you for watching. If you have any queries, let us know in the comment section below.